Hi, it's Menno, and I'm about to make this video that in my whole adult gay life I never thought I'd be making. I'm going to look at the question, do gay men have vaginas? And does having vaginal sex make you any less of a gay man? yeah, it's just bizarre, but here we are. So I thought, okay, let's just dive into it, so to speak. Not the vaginal sex, you know what I mean. God, how do you even start this? I mean, we've arrived at a place where what it means to be gay is no longer about two people of the same sex. And where
some say that even the term same sex is discriminatory.
Now come on, baby, tell me, you must be joking, right?
Shania, I wish I was, but no. We're being led to believe that some lesbians have penises, some gay men have vaginas, and that penis in vagina sex is somehow so super gay, it earns you gold star gay status. So that shall be the focus of this video. Before we jump in, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And you can also support me via Patreon and PayPal. I want to say a massive big thank you to those who support me that way already. You're amazing, and I'm really so grateful for your support. I just went into town yesterday to buy some props for a new music video that I'm working on, and this is one of the things that I got. Yeehaw! Like so many of you, I often ask myself, how did we get to a place where the idea of men with vaginas became a thing and so normalized that even in a sexual health leaflet from the NHS for gay and bi men, ta-da, you can now find a section on how to take HIV prevention medication if you have a vagina in a leaflet for men. No mention of trans, no mention of non-binary, just totally normal that men have vaginas. Right? Funny thing is, being female still matters enough that in this leaflet it has a separate section on how to take this medication in case you have a vagina. Look! So, actual men take two of these pills at least 2 hours before you're planning to have some bum fun. Females take one pill once a day for 7 days in a row before you're planning to have vaginal sex. So the material reality of sex still very much matters. Just don't mention it. This leaflet also uses the word frontal sex to put those mythical men with vaginas at ease who don't want to be reminded of the fact that their vaginas are in fact vaginas. It's just a frontal for frontal sex. Nothing reductive about this woo-woo language at all. I first saw this leaflet in 2021. And at the end of 2021, in December, Max Appenroth, or Appenroth, was crowned Mr. Gay Germany, even though Max is a vagina-bearing adult human female.
Apparently, females make better gay men than gay men, just as men are considered to make better women than women. We also had an adult human female as a finalist in the Mr. Gay England contest in 2021. Her name is Chio, and she boasts online about having a wet-ass pussy, tweets about menstruating, has her ovaries and uterus tattooed onto her thigh, and promotes the idea that gay men can have vaginas.
I want to start plotting on a timeline how this idea that gay men can be females took hold, and who's been pushing it. Think of it as
Mr. Menno and the quest for the gay man's vagina.
And just like Indiana Jones, this will be a franchise, so yes, I'll also be working on Mr. Menno and the Rise of the Lesbian Penis. I think that's gonna be more of a horror film. If we go back just a little bit to August 2018, there's an article in The Advocate that tells us the following. When we talk about gay and bi men, that includes gay and bi trans men too. In other words, females can be gay men. If we go further back, we find a cartoon from August 2013 by a bloke called Bill Roundy. It's called Orientation Police. And that's what I'm going to focus on in this video, because I just think it's so awful. And I want to know how this man justifies it to himself that he calls himself gay when he puts his face up against the vulva and his penis in a vagina. He really doesn't like anyone questioning his so-called gayness and calls those who do the orientation police. I guess that's me. Hi. So for this occasion, I'm going to slip into something a little bit more suitable in a moment. If you have anything else that you've seen that goes back further than 2013, and I'm sure there's plenty, let me know in the comments. I'm also sure that Buck Angel had a significant role to play in this.
For those of you who are just new to Buck Angel, I hate to be the one to pull it all out. Buck Angel was born a biological woman, but of course we all know inside the man was there waiting to come out.
Being a man with a pussy is very difficult for a lot of people, not for me.
You're not a man with a pussy. You're a woman who wants to be perceived as a man.
So anything pushing this idea that some gay men have vaginas, whether it be an article, a cartoon, an interview, a video, whatever you find, just let me know. All right, orientation police coming right up. Okay, let's go on patrol. So here is Bill's cartoon. He posted it on his own website, August 2013. He also posted it on his Medium page, October 2013, and it was also published in the Huffington Post. It comes with a little introduction. Here we go. I'm gay. I date men. Some of those men have vaginas. So sometimes you get guys and they have sex with other guys and they're like, but I'm not gay. This doesn't make me gay. Bill is like the opposite of that. Okay, let's have a look at the first picture. I came out of the closet when I was 18. I'm gay. And then there's two friends, his high school friends, that say, should we tell him that we already knew? And one goes, nah, that's quite funny. So far, so good. Let's go to the next bit. And I stayed as out as possible. How did he do that? He had an earring in his right ear, and then he says that this was a thing in the 90s. He also had like a rainbowy choker necklace type thing and the pink triangle as a badge. Okay, so what that tells me is that for him, being gay wasn't just about, you know, fencing guys. He wanted to make a statement about it through accessories and appearance. And he was president of the college gay group. So I guess for him, the community aspect was also an important part of it and the political side of it. And I can kind of see that if you come out when you're young and you do it with confidence, that you then really want to embrace the gayness and to gay it up to the max, so to speak. I didn't have that experience myself. I came out, well, I never really had the I'm gay jazz hands moment for me. It was a very long, very slow process. And it wasn't until my early 20s that I sort of found peace with it. If you like, with me, it was so bloody obvious anyway that I didn't really have to. It was more a case of people telling me than me telling them. For me, being gay was just about finding a guy, you know, finding a man. So I think a difference here between Bill and I is that for him, being gay is something that he sort of centered his identity around and built his identity around. Whereas for me, being gay is just something I happen to be. And he says, today I've lost most of the accessories. He's lost his hair for sure. But he still wears nail polish. Nail polish left over from his goth face. Okay. But I still hate being taken for straight. Okay, that's interesting. What's so bad about somebody thinking you're straight? I mean, it's one thing wanting people to know that you're gay, but is it really such a big deal if they don't? Maybe it doesn't make him feel special enough. Okay, here we go. It's because he says, in fact, I was and am a gold star gay. A gold star gay, as he explains, is a gay man who's never had sex with a woman like moi. I don't think I've ever described myself as a gold star gay, to be honest, or made a big deal about it, but it is a big deal for Bill. So much so that even when he dates men with vaginas, in other words, females, women, he still wants to hold on to his gold star. Bill, there is nothing gay about a male having sex with a female, no matter how she identifies and what you tell yourself. So your gold star days are over. Sorry. Oh, and here's the police. But lately, my credentials have come under question. And one officer goes, sorry, pal, but technically, another police officer trying to take his gold star away. Look at him holding on to it. No, it's mine. So he uses the word technically, which I find interesting, because technically refers to the reality of our sex bodies, what we do with them, you know, which genitals we rub together and all that. But also by using technically, he's kind of reducing that reality to just a little tiny pesky detail that only the orientation police would take issue with. And I am the police. Absolutely. I'm the gay gatekeeper, making gay gay again. Okay, so his credentials have come under fire because he says, I've dated transgender guys. Three of my last four relationships have been with trans men. So out of these four here on the screen, three were female. What is a trans man, Mr. Bill? He says, men who were assigned female, in quotation marks, at birth, felt that didn't fit and transitioned to, again, quotation marks, male. In woo-woo free language, that means women whose female sex was observed and recorded at birth and who go around pretending to be men. And Bill thinks that's kind of cute. I may have a thing for short guys. No, you have a thing for certain females. And generally, females are shorter than men, so I guess you're in luck. Ooh, and then the questions start. So, says a friend, do you prefer trans guys now? Well, no, it's just I know a lot of trans people, and I kind of like short guys. So then he tells himself, oh, that sounds defensive, doesn't it? Fine. Yes, I like trans men. Bill, you like women, a certain type of woman. That's fine, you know, go fill your loving cup. Be nice if you could do it without faking homosexuality. Okay, and then he says, my libido has its own criteria for when it responds. No shit, Sherlock. And then we get some pictures of where he meets someone, a woman, who is pre-testosterone. So the friend goes, Bill, have you met Jake? Bill goes, hey. And the pre-testosterone woman goes, hey. In what would be just, you know, a woman's voice unaffected by testosterone. But 6 months later, after she's been on testosterone, he is sexually interested, even though he knows full well that she's female. And Bill goes, hey there. And his potential love interest goes, hey, with a slightly deeper voice than before, I'm assuming. Bill, if your libido kicks in that way, when you're with a person that you know is female, then maybe you're just not as gay as you thought you were. Also, 6 months on testosterone doesn't change that much. Obviously, it varies very much from person to person, but it's only after about sort of 6-9 months, generally, that the voice starts to deepen significantly, I think. And facial hair growth takes much longer than 6 months. Again, it varies person to person. So it seems to me that all you need to do as a woman, I guess, to get Bill's interest is to just take off the edge of femininity and he's good to go. And be short, of course, by male standards. And then he says, a lot of trans men are butcher than I am. And that doesn't make them a man. And then he starts talking about clothes and presentation like he did earlier. And they say it's got nothing to do with stereotypes. So he's got a woman's hat with a sparkly snowflake, a velvet scarf, a woman's coat, nail polish, of course. And then he describes a woman who thinks she's a man and what she's wearing, baseball hat, motorcycle jacket, leather collar. Ooh, so manly. Flannel shirt. Okay. And is probably on testosterone. Bill, just as your clothes don't make you any less of a man, her clothes don't make her a man. Or in the words of George Michael. Right. Okay, so even when he is with a short woman by male height standards, who is on testosterone and wears men's clothes and who's butcher than he is, He's still paranoid that others might clock her as female and thus the two of them as a straight couple. So here he says, but being with them causes some people to question my orientation. This can be a simple misgendering mistake or possibly my own paranoia. Ugh, I hope no one thinks we are a straight couple. He puts that down to other people making a misgendering mistake. But if they can tell that his boyfriend is female, despite all the efforts to present as male, then they're not making a mistake. They can simply tell. And I think he knows it. That's why he's paranoid about it. He doesn't want anyone to burst his fake gay bubble. Okay, now he really starts to whinge. But sometimes it's like the orientation police are on patrol. There he is. Give him a label. It seems that the person here who's most concerned about labels is Bill, who drew a picture of himself with a gold star, who wanted to be as out as possible. He says, these are mostly clueless straight people. Okay, we're going to have a look at one of these so-called clueless straights. So your boyfriend is transgender, so he's still physically female. That doesn't sound like a clueless person at all to me. I wouldn't describe it that way. Well, of course you wouldn't, but yeah, basically. So doesn't that make you, here comes the dreaded word again, dun, 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 straight. I, no, it doesn't. But okay, now he gets defensive. Look, I'm gay. That means I only date men. Yes, Bill, so close, keep going. It's just that some of the men I date have vaginas. And here we go again, back to the technical side. Right, so you've had, you know, and then he makes a penis in vagina gesture. And Bill goes, penis in vagina sex? Yeah, straight sex. And Bill sighs because as much as he tries, you just can't get away from the fact that there's nothing gay about putting your penis in a vagina. And it's not just clueless straight people that he takes issue with. And sometimes it comes from gay men with a less nuanced view. What nuance? Dick and dick is gay. Vagina and vagina is gay. Dick and vagina is straight. There is no nuance there. And then he draws a gay guy who goes, vaginas? Ew, I could never. I don't think I could either. I mean, there's different ways of expressing it, but I'm not sexually attracted to women. I don't see why I should make an exception for female genitalia just so Bill can feel less of a fraud. And this is where I really take issue with this cartoon, because it's one thing deluding yourself like Bill does, but it's another than trying to gaslight actual gays into thinking there's something wrong with their sexual orientation and to sort of shame them. Listen to what he says here. Behind the gynophobia. Oh, really? Gynophobia?
Gynophobia, an abnormal or irrational fear of women.
Male homosexuality is now rooted in some kind of phobia? Where are you going with this, Bill? There's a bit of a point. Being attracted to someone includes being attracted to their body. Yes, Bill. What do you think heterosexuality, bisexuality, and homosexuality are based on? But what you like is partially innate and partially acquired. Now, who's policing other people's sexual orientation here? And why, when he talks about himself, is it a matter of my libido has its own criteria and is somehow pure? But when it comes to actual gay men, somehow it's about phobia and prejudice? No, Bill. We just know what we like. What are you going to do? Run a workshop for gay men on how to like women's bits? Hey, Mr. Gay, don't be a bigot. Take a walk in the lady garden.
I beg your pardon. I won't be going down on lady garden. I'll stick with the dick, dear. I'm a gay man, so that should be quite clear. I mean, come on.
There have been workshops like that, by the way. One was called Cunts for Fags. Excuse my French.
This was posted on queerspirit.net and sold as an informative discussion and workshop aimed at queer humans, particularly gay cis men, which means actual gay men, who want to know more about cunts and how to work them. This workshop is the perfect opportunity for motivated humans to learn about vulvas, vaginas, clits, cunts, G-spots, innie holes, bonus holes, cooters, tranny boners, clit boners, or whatever you call yours. I'm sorry, but any man attending this workshop, sorry mate, you're not gay. It reminds me of a song from 1994 by the Out There Brothers called Don't Stop, Wiggle Wiggle, where they sing... Put your ass on my face. I love the way your pussy tastes. Not exactly a gay men's anthem, is it? Although Bill might disagree, he's about to find out the joys of yodeling up the valley.
There have been some awkward moments. And then he draws himself in between the legs of, well, a woman with woman's bits. Now, for an actual gay man, this would be much more than just an awkward moment. But again, Bill has to minimize the reality of it all, even when the truth, or in this case, the vulva of truth, is staring him in the face.
You're going to have to tell me what to do here, because I have no idea.
And I was a little squicked at first, but he really liked it, and I really liked him. Go on, Bill, keep lying to yourself.
She is a he. She is a he. I can keep my gold star, because she is a he.
And then he says, so I got over it. Oh, Bill, what a stunning and brave gold star gay you are, supping from the furry cup, all because of love.
I did it for him. I got over it.
This is an argument that you'll often see on the woo side, that it's all about hearts, not parts. And it's quite an insidious argument because it sort of suggests that homosexuals, and as a consequence also heterosexuals and bisexuals who don't go along with all this woo-woo, that we somehow take a reductive approach towards love and sex, that we're just obsessed with parts and that we don't understand what it's like to truly love someone. Or else we'd be able to just get over it, right? Like Bill. No, we understand that humans are whole embodied beings and that their package is part of the bigger package of being male or female. So we very much look beyond the parts to the bigger picture. And I don't see why I should stop doing that in the so-called name of love. I would do anything for love. But I won't do that. The one being reductive here is Bill. He's taking the female out of vulvas and vaginas and objectifying them as male. And I don't think he's doing that out of some lofty, higher love. He's doing that because it suits his libido and out of a sense of entitlement.
Must have the precious.
And he knows it. So he brings the police back in again. And you know what? I think this orientation police is really his own inner voice telling him that he's a homosexual. Gotcha! No gay man can handle vagina. Well, this one did. Look, hand on his heart. I swear I'm gay, officer. I swear I'm gay. Well, I couldn't do it for a girl, but for my hot boyfriend, sure. Who is the gynophobe now? And there's a little note at the bottom, which is tiny. It says, also, why are you so obsessed with my boyfriend's junk? It's classic Davo. He's trying to take the focus away from the question that he should be answering. Why is he so obsessed with pretending that straight sex is gay? Okay, I'm getting really fed up with this guy, but we're getting to the last bit. Enter one of his ex-boyfriends. I just don't see how a gay man can be with someone without a penis. Bill says, okay, two things. Right, he's going to give it one more try to convince us. Most of what I do when dating someone requires different body parts. Hands, shoulders.
Knees and toes.
Oh, wow, I never knew. I've only ever dated with my nose. And when it is required... See, I find this whole thing really disturbing. This is the second picture now of him being sexually intimate with someone who's female and trying to pass it off
as gay. What he's doing is he's corrupting gayness at its very core, in its most literal, carnal, physical, intimate sense, on the basis of nothing more but pretense and cheap imitation, and under the cloak of somehow being nuanced, progressive, loving.
Ready to take my cock?
Yes, sir.
Well, they're on that shelf. Go pick the one you want.
We're well supplied. You know what, Bill? A strap-on or a dildo has nothing on a dick. I mean, saying it's the same, it's like putting a plastic banana in someone's lunchbox and saying, enjoy your piece of fruit. And here's another difference between two gay men having sex and you and your boyfriend having sex. If she hasn't been on T for that long, or if she comes off it, you could actually get her pregnant. That's not something that two actual gay guys ever have to worry about. And also, I've heard it said by a man who very much knows the difference between being banged by a man and banged by a woman with a strap on, it's not the same. A female pelvis is completely different. You can't get the same angles. You can't get the same thrust. And then there's the one thing that only same-sex attracted people can experience. And in this case, two men. Only a man can know what it's like to be held by a man as a man, to have sex with a man as a man, and to make love to a man as a man. It is a deeply intimate and unique male-only experience, both physically and emotionally. It's one of a kind, and you can't fake it with a female and some sex toys on a shelf. And speaking as a proper gold star gay, here's two more things. One, there's more to being gay than appearances, accessories, and gold stars. It's about being same sex attracted. And that does not include those of the opposite sex, let alone their genitals. Two, one man as a whole, embodied, beautiful, penis-bearing human being will always be better supplied than a woman with a sack of sex toys. Are you going to ask her to splash some yogurt on your face to fake an ejaculation? Come on. Here's a song for you, Bill.
Ain't nothing like the real thing, baby. Ain't nothing like the real thing.
And another one for how you're trying to pass yourself off as a gold star gay.
Oh, yes, I'm the great pretender.
And as for that gold star itself,
let it go, let it go.
Okay, time to wrap it up.
Bill could have just drawn a few pictures where he said, at 18, I came out as gay, ta-da, and then later I realized I was bisexual. Happy days, we all lived happily ever after. But he didn't. Instead, he had to sell homosexuality down the river just because he doesn't want to be seen as straight. I think it is a typical example of what happens when someone is completely gone with the woo-woo. In order to get the validation that they want, they deny reality, claim something that's not theirs, and throw everybody else under the bus. These days, lesbians and gay men are called genital fetishists and transphobic simply for stating that we are same-sex attracted. We're losing single-sex spaces, the right to organize our own single-sex events. There are workshops for men with magical lady feels to convince lesbians to have sex with them. There are workshops for gay men on how to like vagina. I very much see Bill's cartoon as part of embedding this homophobic woo-woo into the public consciousness. And it wasn't his first effort on rewriting the script on what it means to be a gay man. In 2011, he published a comic book called Man Enough, about two gay guys going on a first date. Except that one is, of course, female. With breasts. What an arse. Let me know if you have any other examples of stuff like this, and I'll start plotting it all on my quest for the gay men's vagina board. And also send me anything that you have that I can use for the rise of the lesbian penis. Together we can expose this homophobic shit. Okay, that's enough woo-woo for now, don't you think? And I gotta go, because I have a gold star to polish. Oh. So, ciao for now. See you in the next one. And in the meantime, let's keep it real and keep smiling. Bye!
precious.
To all my PayPal and Patreon supporters, thank you so very much. Special shout out to my big spenders, Helper Open, Mama Turv and the Turventines, Dark Horse, The Lovely Mary, Me Julie, Julia, JPH, and Stephanie. Thank you.